To score a band 8 in academic IELTS writing task 1, it is imperative to understand each type of graph or chart. In this video, I will give you a step-by-step guide to describe the structure of pie chart to receive great results in your IELTS test. If you find this video helpful, then please like, share, and subscribe IELTS Material YouTube channel. Hello everyone, this is Yesha, your IELTS expert from IELTSmaterial.com, helping you to prepare for IELTS, write correct answers, and get a higher band score in your IELTS examination. Now let's discuss the steps to illustrate a pie chart. Starting with step one, which is called as preparing the task, where you will be giving answers to the initial questions. That is, look for the biggest and smallest sections of the pie charts. What do they represent and what is the percentage? You need to make a quick analysis and note down the times, dates, and measurements. See the big picture and avoid getting lost in the details. You will not be writing anything more in detail as this is a summarizing task. When you are confident, you have selected the main features, and then you should carry on to the step two. Moving on to step two, it is organizing your findings into groups, that is into paragraphs. When you have all the information and you have made sure that you have separated the groups, then focus on these topics: the major trends, the major groups, the exceptions, that is the other ideas or other statistical figures, group information, or other similar ideas. So in short, you will be finding the highest, the lowest, the contrasting ideas, and the comparative ideas, and all these have to be taken into two different paragraphs. The next step is to follow the structure. Structure everything into this four paragraph. So the first one is paragraph one, which is going to be the introduction, writing one sentence, explaining what the graphs show, and you can paraphrase the title to complete the introductory paragraph. The next is paragraph two, that is you will be writing two sentences, and this paragraph is called as overall or overview paragraph, wherein you will be summarizing your description in just two sentences. So what are the major overall trends or changes and the overall idea that can be presented in this paragraph? The next one is paragraph three. Here you will take in the notes that you have already taken related to the highest and the lowest or the other ideas, and you will be elaborating these ideas into two paragraphs. So paragraph three will talk about the information that you have separated in step two. Focus on the first group. Then again, you also have to write a paragraph and another paragraph talking about the other pie chart or the other group. So here, talk about the information that you have separated in step two and focus on the second group. In this manner, you will write four paragraphs, and hence the structure of a pie chart or a chart or the task one of writing module is called as four-part structure. If you want to learn the important vocabulary to describe maps in academic writing task one, then check out our video on important vocabulary for maps in iButton or video description. Now let's take a look on the model answer. This is a pie chart, and we have taken only one pie chart, which is talking about the world food consumption. The question might be in this way, that this particular graph is describing about different categories, and it is talking about the world food consumption of the year 2014. And there are different categories, that is vegetables, rice, meat, fruits, cereals, bread, and fish. And these have been represented with the help of percentage. So my first sentence is the introductory sentence, where I'm introducing what type of chart or graph it is. I've made sure that I write it very correctly. That is, the pie chart shows the shares of world food consumption, that is total world food consumption, held by each of seven different food types in 2014. One, two, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have 7 different food types and the year in 2014. This is my paragraph 1, or this is my introductory statement. Taking up the overall statement, I will be writing here completely about what I can see overall. Overall, I can see that global consumption is widely dispersed among food types. No one type has the majority share. So here I can see that it has been elaborated and properly distributed. So there is no one major type which has the major contribution. And hence I can say that animal-based foods, that is meat and fish, do make up the majority of consumption when added together. It is important to note, however, that based on the information in this pie chart, no conclusions can be drawn about the dietary diversity of an individual person. So this is actually talking about all the individuals and the food consumption completely taking up the world population. Finally, in the last paragraph, what I have done is I've taken third and fourth paragraph together as one paragraph and explaining about meat and then the fish, which is standing at the second position. And then I'm talking about cereals, and fourth position is taken by fruits. The fifth position is taken by vegetables, and the smallest food group is actually taken by consumption. Vegetables and bread are taken together in the same sentence, while the last sentence contains the smallest food group in terms of world consumption, and that is rice. I have made sure that I'm writing the numbers as well to describe them properly or to describe them distinctively. Now let's sum up and include, or at least get to know, what we need to include in our pie charts. So pie chart review. Take an example question and decide what type of language we will need to describe it. So you should start practicing after watching this video. Naturally, we need language to describe proportions. So especially in the pie chart, we need a language to describe proportions. Some keywords are percent. This can be taken together and this can be taken separately as well. And then percentage, we need proportion, we need amount, we need share. So these type of vocabulary will be used in describing the structure of pie chart or the numbers in pie chart. At the same time, we must be able to use the language of comparison, where we will be comparing two different groups, the first group and the second group. And we also can compare the countries which has the largest and the smallest share. So some keywords can be most and the least, largest or the smallest, more or less, and greater and the smaller. So you should know the adjectives through which you can make the comparisons. I hope the step-by-step guide will help you in writing the pie charts effectively. If you think that this video has been informative and understandable, then please let us know about the same in the comment section below. For more free IELTS learning, please follow our channel. And for this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe IELTS Material YouTube channel for more IELTS exam updates. Thank you.